live look at the 35W Bridge. Of course, you are looking at the relatively recently constructed bridge, finished back in 2008. Because 15 years ago today, the bridge that once stood in its spot collapsed. That collapse during rush hour traffic killed 13 people and injured 145 others. This image was taken by then University of Minnesota student Stacy Banks. She lived just blocks away from the bridge, putting her at the scene just minutes after it happened.
Summer's very, very busy, yes, summer into fall.
Busy because in addition to photographing weddings, Stacy Banks freelances for the Associated Press.
So when I saw this for the first time, this image took my breath away.
But her most memorable photos are from 15 years ago.
This is part of the bridge right here that fell down.
Stacy was a photographer for the U of M student newspaper. Before she saw the collapse, she heard it.
Sitting with my roommates on the second floor of our home, we were three blocks north of the bridge. Heard something and felt something very faint. And I went out on our balcony and I saw the part of the bridge sticking straight up.
You see it from your house?
I could see it from my house, yeah. I left instantly.
This was the first photo Stacy took down by the collapsed bridge.
And they had been lining up the injured victims on pieces of plywood, waiting to get them taken out of there. I just remember making eye contact with some people and everyone was in such shock. So I had walked up here on the bridge.
Stacy took photos until after dark.
Got the pictures on the computers and we started looking at them, and I don't think it was until then when we realized we were really down there.
A front row seat to one of Minnesota's greatest tragedies, captured on Stacy's camera, etched into her memory.
Changed me from the perspective of knowing how precious every moment is.
So unbelievable for so many people who lived through it that day. But I mean, obviously, she was 21 or 22.
Those pictures when that happened. Crazy. Brings you back to that moment for sure.
It sure does. So back in 2008, of course, just a year after this collapse happened, a new law was passed which required MnDOT to find the bridges in our state most in danger of failing and then put them on an accelerated schedule for repair. So when MnDOT did that, they found 172 bridges across the state.
Terrifying.
That needed work. Yep. But since 2008, here's the good news. 112 of them have already been replaced, 24 have been renovated. So they have made quite a bit of work in the years since that
collapse. Any people that lived in Minnesota or around Minnesota at that time, driving over bridges was terrifying after that happened, because they're like, what if?
What if, exactly. And you remember exactly where you were when
it happened. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, Jen, thanks for that report. All right, parents.